the car and drop the gas at you.
21 of 26. We missed a few. We made enough free throws.
Yeah, Litchford down stretch.
5, 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Welcome back, Bear River basketball fans. This is Clint Payne, joined by Coach Scott Hunt. Bears victorious here tonight, 67-57 at home over the Ogden Tigers. Coach, started out a little shaky there in the first half. I was a little bit worried. We came out, I don't know if you want to call it flat, maybe a little lackadaisical, trail 28-23 at halftime. What were your thoughts on that first half? I mean, our defense just didn't quite look as sound as normal as, and we missed a few shots, too.
Oh, I thought we came out flat. I don't know why. I mean, we're playing a 4A team, an Ogden team. I don't know why we didn't give them any respect. It's beyond me. But we come out flat, missed shots early, turned the ball over early, playing with little emotion, little passion. And, that's unacceptable. I mean, that's all there is to it. It's flat out unacceptable to come out in a high school basketball game on your home floor and have that kind of first half performance. It's just unacceptable. For Bear River High School, that's not how we play. That's not what we're about. And we came out that first half, and, I just wasn't happy with our effort. Passing, we turned the ball over, I think, 8 or 9 times that first half. Our shooting percentage was like 30%. Right. I think we were 8 for 24 or 5, whatever it was. It showed little focus, little concentration on our part. And, we needed to get tuned up a little bit to come out here and give some effort. I thought the effort third quarter was much better.
No doubt about it, Coach. Your defense phenomenal in the third quarter. 6 third quarter points. What did you tell them at halftime? What changes did you make? You came out a few different looks. We saw Bucks and one on Hunter Clark. We saw, you ran a little more X. What was the halftime
match? The halftime was just about effort and pride, playing with some pride. I thought we played with a little pride in the first half, and that's, like I said, that is inexcusable to come out in a high school basketball game. You're representing your community in your high school and play with little passion. It's just not right. So, we challenge them to come out here in the second half and play like they know how to play. I mean, why come out and not represent? And so we challenge them a little bit. We kind of challenged the heart a little bit, and they came out and we got right into X. We didn't mess around. We came out in just a half court. I wanted to get some energy going, and we came out in that half court trap with energy. I told them, if you're not going to play, you got one chance, you're done. You'll be over here with me because I can't tolerate a lack of effort. And I thought the effort was much better that third quarter. We got steals, we got energy, we got going, and it flipped the whole thing. Now, why can't we do that at the beginning of the game? I'm not sure, but it made a difference. And then, I still. Our rebounding effort was horrendous. Right here at the end of the game, with the game on the line, we couldn't find a rebound.
Right.
And that's inexcusable again. I don't understand what's going on here, but we got to find a way to rebound. Again, I look at myself. What can I do better? What can I do different as a coach? And certainly we'll evaluate that. I got to do a better job. But we got to get on the boards. We got to make plays to help our team win.
Now, you've got plenty of game time this week, Coach, with two more coming up to get that fixed and, make sure they're crashing the boards and boxing out and finding bodies. Jake Daly played extended minutes tonight with Tristan Hart falling in foul trouble. Jake, I thought, did a pretty good job. The sophomore came in there, gave you a couple of big buckets, maybe turned the tide, and giving valuable experience.
I like Jake out there at the end. He did the best he could under the circumstances, which was adequate. The problem was we had Tristan on the bench where he had no business being.
Right.
He's got to be smarter than that. I mean, he's got 4 fouls. He's reaching out here at midcourt. Come on.
Yeah, a couple of taken tackles.
And we almost gave the game away because he's on the bench.
Yeah.
We got to be smarter than that in those situations. And I think he'll learn from that. But nonetheless, that really was costly. And it gave them some momentum. We didn't handle ourselves well at the end of the game. We turned the ball over. We were a little bit panicked. And Tristan is a calming influence on this team. And when he goes out, our quarterback's gone. And we're bringing in the second, third string quarterback. And it makes a huge difference. Although, like you said, I thought Jake did a great job in replace.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I like Butcher's effort tonight in that boxing one on Hunter Clark. That's a tough matchup for anybody. Hunter Clark's a good basketball player. And Bridger, when you went to that box and one, tried to take away his airspace, contest every shot. I like Bridger's defense.
Well, he did a good job. We went at X, and at the NEX, it's a give and take. We got a lot of energy going. We got some steals. They missed shots early in the quarter in X. Finally, he's going to get some looks in X because you're trapped.
It's a gambling
defense.
That's right.
Over top, you're going to give up some looks. And, as soon as he started making a couple, we had to change because, he's the kind of player that hits one, he might hit five. So, that's when we made the adjustment to go into a little bit of a boxing one and try to do our best there. And They had a couple other kids that stepped up, 21. I think that's
Spencer Johnson hit a couple threes, yeah, and Jackson Park, yeah, his brother. Yeah, yeah, they did. Yeah,
so, I mean, it's a tough matchup, and kids got to play. But, you know, we pushed it out to, I think, a 16-point lead, and then we had, like, three plays in a row that just were not smart.
In a minute and a half, they cut that to 7 points.
Absolutely, because we foul, we turn the ball over, we're just not smart. So those are things we got to clean up, and those are things I, as a coach, I got to do better coaching and instructing.
I know it drives you crazy, but I got to ask, one of these times, Richford's not going to sit out an entire quarter. You're going to get 30 or 35 points out of him. You have 20 tonight, missed the entire second quarter and half the third quarter, Coach. I know he's a little bit snake bit with the officials, but are they watching for that hand check? Is that what they're watching for up there, Coach?
It's a matter of, he's got to have an awareness. You know, I mean, he's got to know that he's a value to our team when he's on the floor. We've talked about it. We've talked about it. Practice, we talk about it. And he just got to do a better job. I mean, the second foul he picked up was at a breakaway layup.
Right.
I said, Mike, give him the darn layup.
Yeah,
you're more valuable than 2 points down the dang floor.
Yeah, we need
but,
to.
But, I mean,
floor.
Those are things that we got to learn. And they're young. I mean, they're juniors early in the season. And they're learning. I'm hoping that they learn through these experiences. But, yeah, we got to have Mike on the floor. We got to have Tristan on the floor.
Well, they seem to be a very coachable coach. I think they'll learn and dig in. We have two more games this week, Park City. Tomorrow night, just turn around. Let's do it again. What do we know about the minors, Coach?
Very little.
I don't either, to be honest. It was too early. I haven't seen, I haven't had a chance to look, dig into it. So I guess we're going to learn together, aren't we?
Yeah, you know, with the three games last weekend, and then we got Sunday off, and Monday yesterday, we're cleaning some things up. But you got two, and so I just, and then you got Ogden. Yep. So, you know, our focus was kind of with Ogden. Now we got it. Tomorrow, I'll go find some stuff on Park City, and hopefully by game time, we'll have a little game plan ready to go.
When you prepare for back-to-backs like games like that, Coach, you don't have time to, obviously, like you said, you'll go find some stuff tomorrow. It's really more about what you do as a team, your execution.
Yeah, I'm not a real big, until we get to, you know, league and maybe tournament games, the most important thing is what you do, what we do well, we execute, and we're fundamentally sound, and that should hold you about against anybody. But, yeah, you know, in a game like this, where it's a two-game, I usually look at the first game and take one game at a time. If I had a little more time, I probably would have looked a little bit more at Park City.
Yeah, I understand that completely. Let's go get another win tomorrow night. Let's get these couple things we talked about fixed. Bears win tonight, 67-57. So congratulations on another one, 4-1 on the season. Let's keep it rolling, Coach.
Hey, I'm all for it. It sounds great. Thank you.
That's Coach Scott Hunt. This has been the Gem Electric Coaches post-game show. Make sure you tune in tomorrow night again. Bears take on the Park City Miners here in Garland at Memorial Gymnasium. 7 o'clock tip time. We'll be on the air at 6:45. Coach told you the things that he's going to work on here and things that we need to fix to get better as a basketball team. One thing I love about Coach Hunt, says candor, he doesn't sugarcoat a lot, and he's straightforward. He's that way with his players. He's that way when it comes to talking about his basketball team. We've got a great coach, a great team we have here at Bear Fans. Again, 4-1, Bears paced by Mike Litchford with 20 points tonight. The only other Bear in double figures was the sophomore, Jake Daly, with 10. But a lot of balance. Look at this. Tristan with 6. Easton Payne with 2. Mason Anderson with 2. Nate Daly with 8. Gunnar Sorensen with 6. Marshall Pond had a free throw. Bridget Buse with 8. Riley Fonsbeck with the free throw. And Caleb Jensen with the 3-pointer. So getting contributions from everybody, Bear fans. That's what you like to see, that kind of balance. Well, we appreciate you tuning in. This is 104.9 FM, home of the Bear River Bears. We're going to turn around and do it again tomorrow night when the Bears host the Park City Miners. Drive home safe, Bear fans. We'll see you tomorrow night.